Dressing up at school began early in my career, like at Crabapple, with nerd days, and dressing up with live animals, and selling Earth Day t-shirts to wear on Earth Day, and also dressing appropriately for working outside. In 1994, I started working at North Hall Middle School in sixth grade, where we had all kinds of celebrations. We celebrated in social studies, and we also celebrated with music and song. We celebrated with pep rallies, school plays, and in 2000, we started celebrating Read Across America in March. And young people and teachers alike dressed as their favorite characters out of a book. In 2001, we dressed up to support our country after 9/11. And we introduced all kinds of other interesting accessories and colors for various celebrations like luaus and Halloween. And then there was the gene role playing, decision making activity in the kingdom, and rainbow glasses. They're a fun accessory because you see rainbows while wearing them. And then there was sixth grade social studies. And seventh grade genetics role playing activities when I introduced the dress up box. The dress up box was very popular. Now would be a good time for parents with their children at home to play dress up and do some role playing activities. It was always fun to have a little doctor's kit and my daddy's old stethoscope and sphygmomanometer and my mama's old clothes. And then we had certain fundraisers that were a lot of fun and entertaining, where people dressed up. And then we socked it to drugs every year during Wed Women Week. And then obviously Christmas time is a good time to dress up. And so were pep rallies and field days and Renaissance festivals soon to come, and of course drama and plays that were conducted at the high school. Oh, and then there was Evening of Excellence. Pouncey gave me that. And I wore that flapper dress when I was first married. Got some good use out of it. In Cinco de Mayo, when studying food from the garden, And in 2007, when we went to the dome. Oh, and Grace decorated my board for me every day. Nerd day. I wore Newsom's big shoes. And the occasional unique item that came in from someone's home. Oh, yep, there's the doctor bag. And scarves and skirts and loungewear. But I'm telling you, that flapper dress got a lot of wear. Still have that dress-up box in the attic. In 1 year, we introduced fake blood. And some students brought their own props. But it was all to solve a genetic problem. One year, 8th grade did Frontier Day. And they all dressed up like people on the frontier. And of course, we love to wear things for Christmas. And on field days, every homeroom wears the same color. Gloves and masks were optional when dissecting frogs. But to play the part. And then the games in the kingdom. They weren't really dress up, but they definitely were simulations. That was in 2010. We had hospital coats that made them feel like doctors. And we did blindfold taste tests. Blindfolds were very handy. And we had Renaissance festivals. We were organisms in the North Hall Kingdom, the Queen's Army, and squirrels in the North Hall Kingdom after a fire raged through, destroying all the food. And Nerd Day. And there's the dress-up box again. And that was one of the skits. And that was another Renaissance festival. Oh, and our taste smell lab. Those are owl families in the kingdom. Competing for resources using inherited adaptations. We did a little bit of gardening every year. Everybody got a chance to try the equipment. We made DNA bracelets. We practiced flexibility. And some are very flexible. Yes, pajama day. Put drugs to sleep, dodging an enemy, power walking, outrun them, grow straight and tall, be in water molecules in the kingdom, at several stations. Critters got a balance. Yoga's good for that. And hula hoops are good for several things. Yep, science lends itself to fun activities in the classroom, which can translate into fun activities at home during this CVC period in history. And so can studying germs, learning more about them. There's the old germ box. And the germs are useful in the games. They adhere to the stick with Velcro. And I know they're all mine in the web of life. Must whistle if you're a woodpecker and be able to perch. Cones come in handy, as do kittens. Being blood cells in the bod. Oh, and running horsepower. And hat day. And the final challenge to get the winner. Hat day. And magnetic darts were very useful. Renaissance festival and activities. The golfing was also very useful in the kingdom. Field day. And the limbo pole and the nature trail. Oh, and picnic tables. I noticed tons of picnic tables at North Hall last visit. And then my last year, I always took pictures of the winners in the games. And I had lots of winners all the time. I fed them well. And I wore skorts a lot. The jump rope simulated escaping from the flames or getting through a waterfall and all kinds of things. My toy box was full of interesting adaptations. Foam dodgeballs, straws, magnetic darts, and the garden. Weaving through the cones, a selfie with my camera. Spinach and green beans, and more balancing act. Oh, and there was multiplication and division. That's when we made plankton. Sinking slowly. And here we made Cambrian critters out of clay. And critter hide and seek. And DNA models. . 2014 was full of wonderful young people willing to participate in all the games I had created in the kingdom. It was a great year, even though it was cut short. DNA bracelets and everything. A lot with the microscope. Egg experiments. And celebrations. And dissections. It was a great ending to a 30-year career.